Now that you've started a project, it's time to get to know the interface. Let's start from the top. In the top left corner, you have the ability to navigate back to the dashboard, as well as the name of your project. In the top right corner, you'll have different buttons like undo and redo, keyboard shortcut panel, and buttons for both import and export. Moving on to the left-hand side. Here you'll find sketches, which is a way for you to make different versions of your project that you can compare later. Statistics, which will show you all the key values for your project, like GFA, plot size, parking demand, and so on. Spaces is where you define how many units, what type of unit, the target mix, and so on. Elements is a coming feature that shows the structure of your project in a topological drop-down format. And add simulation, which lets you add different simulations like daylight potential and view analysis. You'll find all future simulations here as well. Now let's talk about the bottom row. In the bottom left corner, you can find the properties panel. The properties panel has three different tabs. Default, which changes based on what you have selected. So if you have a building selected, you can change the roof type, for example. Regulation, for defining national building codes and project-specific regulations. And terrain, which lets you change how buildings interact with the terrain. We'll explain more in depth about the properties panel in another tutorial.
In the middle of your bottom row, you'll find tools for creating plots, buildings, context, vegetation, and terrain. These tools are what you'll use to create your project. We'll have a separate in-depth tutorial on this toolbar.
Moving on to the right-hand side, you have a 2D, 3D view toggle, zoom to fit, which fits anything you've selected in the view, and a turntable mode, which rotates the model continuously. Sun position, which lets you change the sun position based on the time of day and year. A distance measuring tool.
A snapping toggle, which lets you decide if building elements will snap together.
The layer panel, which lets you toggle the visibility of different elements in the viewport, like for example hiding all roofs. An LOD panel that lets you visualize your model in a lower or higher level of detail. The display mode panel, which gives you view modes like building category, unit type, where the core is located, etc. Next up, we have the terrain mode panel. These modes give you an easy way to visualize, for example, terrain sloping or elevation. It also gives you the ability to view your project with satellite imagery if you've imported context when starting the project. The bottom three buttons are sort of like presets for the layer panel. It gives you a quick way to toggle between exterior, interior, or underground view.